fresh off his surprise show of unity with President Trump, renewed his doubts Tuesday about Steve Bannon's 2018 primary threats.
We had an experience in 2010 and 2012 nominating candidates in primaries who couldn't win in the general election. I mentioned a few names for you: Christine O'Donnell, Sharon Angle, Todd Akin, Richard Murdoch. What do they all have in common? They're in private life, and a Democrat is in the Senate. So our goal is to nominate people who can actually win in November. It's important to remember that those who lose elections don't get to make policy. Only those who win elections actually get to make policy. And so our strategy going forward is to protect our incumbents and to help people get nominated who actually can win elections, because that's the way you get to change America.
Michael Steele is the managing director of Hamilton Place Strategies and former press secretary for House Speaker John Boehner. He's in Washington for a GOP strat chat. Welcome to you, Michael.
Good to be with you.
All right, a lot to unpack here, but first of all, let me ask you, how important is the relationship between President Trump and Majority Leader McConnell at this point?
It's absolutely crucial. Nothing substantial that the president wants to accomplish, nothing substantial that the American people elected him to do, gets done without the United States Senate, and that means Mitch McConnell. They don't need to be friends. The president doesn't need to join Senator McConnell for a tailgate before the Louisville football game. Senator McConnell doesn't need to join the president for a round of golf at one of his golf courses. But they need a trusting and effective working relationship, and I think that's what they're trying to get to.
What about Steve Bannon's threats against some GOP incumbents? Is that a bigger problem for President Trump or Senator McConnell in the long run?
Well, it's just a dumb idea for both sides. Look, the way I'm a conservative, the way you get conservative policy goals enacted into law is to have more conservatives elected to the United States House and Senate. There are scores of states where President Trump won, sometimes with double-digit majorities, currently represented by a Democratic senator. Those states like Indiana, Missouri, Montana, Florida, those are places where we can replace a Democrat with a conservative Republican. That's the way you expand our majority. That's the way you get things done, like tax reform, like repealing and replacing Obamacare.
So, Michael, how do you then read what happened in Alabama, where you have Roy Moore as the victor over the candidate that the president and Mitch McConnell endorsed, Luther Strange?
Well, I think that in a state as conservative in Alabama, there is a possibility that a candidate as polarizing as Moore may be able to prevail in the general. But that's far from usual in states across the country.
All right. Well, let's talk about a little bit more about this relationship between the president and Senator McConnell. One thing they both highlighted at their news conference Monday was their desire to install more judges. What is the tactical advantage of that as you see it?
Well, judges, particularly with lifetime appointments, are a way to extend the goals and the governing process, the governing impact of a conservative president and a conservative Senate and well into the future. And so this is a shared priority. I think it's notable that the president's only real win in terms of something that has gotten through Congress is the nomination of Supreme Court Justice Gorsuch.
And then in terms of the conservative base, those elements of the conservative base who look very closely at these judicial appointments, how critical is that message? Is that why we were hearing that emphasis in the Rose Garden?
Absolutely. Look, the judiciary, for better or worse, plays an outsized role in American life. There are issues of conscience, issues of faith, issues of free speech and public morality that are decided by our courts. And so the people making those decisions are critically important, particularly to the base of the Republican Party.
All right. Finally, I want to talk about one of the last elections of the year. Vice President Mike Pence campaigned for Republican Ed Gillespie this weekend in Virginia. He's running for governor there against Democrat Ralph Northam. Do you think that the White House should get more involved in that race?
I think that Ed Gillespie is a terrific candidate for Virginia. I'm sure he's working closely with the White House on the degree of their involvement. I know that most of the polls have him slightly behind, but let's remember that in 2014, Ed Gillespie ran way ahead of all the polls in his governor's race in the Commonwealth of Virginia, and I think he's got a very good chance to close strong and win this race.
As you know, Hillary Clinton won Virginia in 2016. How closely are Republicans paying attention to that race?
Well, these off-year states, both Virginia and usually New Jersey, are often seen as a harbinger. But in this case, I think it's probably more about local issues and the Virginia economy than it is any sort of national trend.
All right. We will see what happens. Michael Steele in Washington for us. Michael, thanks so much for joining us. Appreciate it.
Thank you.